Hello, people. Today I wanted to talk about something that is affecting everybody on YouTube today. Today was the day that YouTube shut off monetization to thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands. Did I mention thousands of people? Yeah. Let me see. Hold on a minute. Okay, I have the wind resilience on, the wind reduction, whatever you want to call it. So today is the day that YouTube has turned off lots of people's monetization on their channels, to include my channel, to say the least. And, I wonder if YouTube is really doing the right thing. Making the bar, you know, 1,000 subscribers, 40,000. Is it 40,000? I think it's 4,000 a month, or so, I don't know, some other gauge of view counts, right? So as I think about this, you know, and there's other channels. I won't mention what kind of channels, but they're, well, just for instance, there's other channels out there that are getting monetization because they meet those requirements. They meet the 1,000 subscriber count, and they meet the view count to have monetization. Now, here's the interesting thing, right? So YouTube said, we're going to go ahead and take off monetization for those small channels. They won't really notice it. And we're doing that because, well, not because they're bad actors, but bad actors, you know, won't be able to get those kind of numbers. Are you serious, YouTube? You think that bad actors don't get views and they don't get subscribers? What a joke. To say that somebody who is putting out garbage videos, or somebody who has a kind of a crazy, you know, crazy thinking, or whatever you say that a bad actor is, if you think that those bad actors, as you put it, are not going to be able to get a fan base or get those views and get those subscribers, it'd be like saying, hey, I don't like Rush Limbaugh, but he has lots of viewers. Or I don't like Howard Stern, he has lots of viewers. You know, it's ridiculous. You already put down these set of rules previously that said you don't want people talking about controversial subjects. That's pretty cool. This is actually one of the very coolest. Look at that. It has like it's a Jeep. Off-road Jeep that has like a star. That is really impressive. You already have these rules and filters that automatically demonetize videos for content for people that talk about politics and, you know, maybe what's going on in the news and a lot of other things that are against the guidelines of, you know, of topics and content. Yeah. Wasn't that enough already? That you would send these demonetized videos that the bot of sorts, that the algorithms found with keywords or whatnot, or that they were picked up because, you know, the voices are, the words of the video are being picked up, the content of the video is being transcribed into by the same robot that's making your video be able to be read by the hearing impaired service, which I believe that's how it's happening, because I can load a video and have a good title and still you don't like the content, but yet, how do you know that what I said, other than it being transcribed somewhere by some bot? So yeah, that's happening. But needless to say, Let's go over here and look at one of these potholes, by the way. We talked about potholes this morning. Let's look at potholes. Oh, yeah. Shookie dookie. So there's these potholes. I just want to show you guys what we're dealing with. That is a pothole. Oh man, this is really great. This one down here, this is notoriously a pothole. And I didn't really plan on doing this, but just for what it's worth, I don't think anybody's washing their car today at the wash place. But like, that's a pothole. You don't want to definitely drive over that thing there, because if you like drove over that, and that could really mess up your car. Here comes somebody. Are they going to hit it? Or not? I bet you they're not. No, they're not going to hit it. They really, really do not get close to it. There's a lot. That's a pothole there. You're probably wondering, I'm making a video about potholes. But really, that's not how it started. Anyways, the YouTube service, as we're scanning the area for potholes, the YouTube service is, there's a ginormous one right there. Look at the size of that pothole. I don't want to step in there. I'm going to go, what? See, nobody's coming. There's more. I mean, they're just everywhere. If you, I'm going to tell you right now, if you're a biker, this is not good. That is a pothole, to say the least. It even has, like, the stuff where they had filled it up and it's all over the place. That's good sometimes. There's a giant pothole over there in the middle of the road. Here's a piece of the road. I mean, look at that. Look at that chunk of the road, man. That's humongously huge. Yeah, that's big. That is a pothole, to say the least. Boom! It's like John Madden waiting to tell you about the potholes there. I mean, let's just zoom in at it. I'm just going to, like, zoom in a little bit. That is a huge pothole. I mean, look at that thing. That's a beaut. All right, let's get going here. Gonna watch the street. We didn't get ran over. We get, it's like someone, that's not good. Don't run over it. All right. There's another pothole right there. That's huge. All right. This really wasn't supposed to be the pothole video, but since I was out, I thought I would discuss some potholes. All right, maybe I'll cut that all out and make a pothole video. No, I'm just joking. I don't want to make two videos. Anyways, back to the topic at hand. On the way back now. So back to YouTube. Why not go back to using the filtration as you have and utilize the thousands of, I think it was like 10,000 or more employees that were going to be used to actually scrub videos and scrub the content and do their job, instead of upping it to 1,000 because you think that their content is from bad actors. Now here's my thing about this, right? Here's what I have to say about this as I gather my thoughts for one more minute. YouTube has a lot of content on their, and I'm not saying that my video is going to be something that maybe a lot of, you know, everybody has a lot of content on there that may not be commercial grade videos, you know, or a series that's made professionally, like a Casey Neistat video or something like that. And, you know, a vlog may be kind of amateurish. But we've had ads on our content for a very long time because the viewers get to see the ads and they click on the ads and they watch the ads and then people go click on something. It's kind of like ads on a website, right? It's not about how great the content is. It's that you had viewers watching. So now the deal is that the ads are on videos that they just people the advertisers don't like. that they don't disagree with them, that they disagree with, or that, and that, and whatnot. So instead of just saying we're going to limit you because you don't, your content is not so popular, why don't we start going back and looking at what it is they're putting out, and are advertisers willing, and what advertisers are willing to put ads on those content so that those views can be seen. So, yeah, that's my theory of today. That's all I had to say today. And hope you had some excitement there looking at potholes also. So with that all said, talk to you guys later. Have a safe one. Be safe. This has been the Detroit Vlogger.